हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम अमित कपिला, वर्किंग फॉर एंटरप्राइज डीबी फॉर बोथ पोस्टग्रे एसक्यूएल एंड ओपन सोर्स एंड एडवांस सर्वर। आई एम हेयर टू प्रेजेंट ऑन फास्टर पोस्टग्रे एसक्यूएल। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन आई विल शेयर ऑल द परफॉर्मेंस इम्प्रूवमेंट्स वी हैव डन फॉर रीड्स एंड राइट्स। सो बिफोर गेटिंग इन टू द प्रेजेंटेशन, आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर वाई आई हैव केप्ट द टाइटल एज फास्टर पोस्टग्रे एसक्यूएल। In Enterprise DB, our leader, Mr. Mark, always tells us that we want to make PostgreSQL faster in all respects from what it is currently. So I have stolen this word from there and kept as my presentation title. But yeah, overall, it will cover all the performance improvements and how we have made PostgreSQL faster. In this presentation, overall, I will share about all the read performance and scalability improvements we have done, the write performance and scalability, whatever we have done. And then some of my experiments I would like to share with you, which I have done during my write performance improvement work, which could lead to some future work. And then all the other performance work we have done in 9.6. Finally, I would like to also share the performance, how it has improved, how the PostgreSQL has improved from 9.1 to 9.5. To start with, the read performance improvements we have done in 9.6. In this, the first and the biggest improvement we have done for the read performance is that we have made pinning and unpinning of a buffer to use atomic operations instead of spin locks. This is the one of the most frequent operation we have to do while reading the data. So this has improved the performance greatly on the workloads where the workload fits in the cache. And on a very large x86 system, we have seen that up to 8 times the performance improvement has been done. And also, it also improves the performance of query which touch the same buffer multiple times over high frequency. This work is mainly done by Andres, who is sitting here, as well as Alexander. So many thanks to them. We will see the data after this, but this is a very big improvement we have done in 9.6. And the second is that we have improved the locking in the DynaHash share tables, which is used for multiple purposes in the PostgreSQL. For the read workload, also, like, for storing the buffer mappings between shared buffers and the pages, we store that information in this dynamic hash table. So right now also it has many partitions, but there is a common free list which was getting access through a common spin lock, and there was a lot of bottleneck in multiple workloads. And now we have partitioned that free list such that for access to any partition, no, there is no need to take the spin lock. So combining both these improvements, and there are other few, but we see a lot of big performance improvement in read workloads. So the first, and this data is mainly on the very high end machine where we have lot of sockets and 64 cores. So it depends on the hardware what kind of performance improvements you will see. But on this machine, we have seen up to 2.5 times performance increase at 128 client counts. And you can see that the scalability also starts increasing from 32 clients and all the way up to 128 clients. So this is a very, very big improvement for the read workloads. And this is the second case again for the read workloads, but where the data doesn't fit in shared buffers. However, it fits in the overall memory of the system. Here also we have seen up to 2.4 times performance increase at 104 clients. And the scalability also has improved across all the client counts. So again, this is a very major performance improvement for read workloads. The next I will talk about is the write performance and scalability work we have done in 9.6. So in this area, first I would like to talk about the proc array lock contention. This is one of the lock which we need to acquire to acquire the snapshots as well as in the shared mode and to at the commit time in exclusive mode to clear the transaction IDs. So now when many processes are trying to commit at once, each one of them needs to perform their action serially because this lock is taken in exclusive mode at commit time. So the technique we have used to improve the concurrency around this lock is we call group clearing, where all the actions need to be performed for clearing the transaction is done by one group leader, and which decreases the number of times we have to take this lock. So in brief, the idea is something like this: whichever backend or whichever process wants to clear its transaction ID adds itself to the list, and the first one who has added itself is to the list becomes the group leader, and it clears the transaction ID behalf on all of the others. So this way, we reduce the number of times we have to take this exclusive lock. On Power8 machine, we have observed up to 30% performance improvement at 64 clients and 133% at 256 clients for PGBench read-write workload. For details, you can refer this blog for improvements only via this improvement work. The next work for the read-write transactions is to reduce some contention around C-log control lock. So this is the lock we acquire to read the transaction status so that we can find out whether the tuple is visible or not, and to update the transaction status at the commit time. So on a multiprocessor system, it is quite possible to have many C-log page requests that could come at the same time, and which could lead to an access for a disk access, because the number of C-log buffers which are in memory were very less. So by increasing the number of C-log buffers, we could see a great performance improvement, because now most of the access is done via buffers. So for unlocked tables, I could see up to 90% performance improvement at 128 clients just after this improvement. And again, the next work, which is not directly related to scalability, but it gives us lot of stability in the TPS for the read-write workload, is to reduce the I/O stalls during checkpoint. Right now, currently, all the writes to the data files are done via the OS page cache, which can sometimes lead to accumulation of many dirty buffers. So, and then at the end, checkpoint used to flush all the buffers to the disk. The now idea is to basically make check pointer or whoever is whichever process can write perform the write, they can do the writes after some configurable number of disk writes. And each of the process like backend BG writer or the checkpoint which performs the write operations can do so via their individual GUC variables. So we need to be cautious about setting these variables appropriately. So this is the also work done by Andres, which has improved the stability for writes in the PostgreSQL in 9.6. So for this is the performance improvement and the scalability we see for read-write workload. Basically, in this after 64 clients, we always see a very big dip till 9.5 in the performance. With this improvement, you can see the that the scalability, the performance increases up till 128 clients. And maybe if somebody has more cores machine, it might scale to higher numbers as well. And up to 95% performance increase has been observed at 128 clients, which is a very big number for considering that improving the write workloads is a very tricky task. In terms of write, the next work that has been done in PostgreSQL community is the bulk load performance and scalability. As of now, bulk loading either done via copy or insert command. Both in both cases, the performance tanks when we try to bulk load from multiple processes. The basic problem was that each relation extension request is currently was being done serially, so that could leads to a performance dip as soon as multiple processes tries to do the bulk load. And we have done some experimentation which has revealed that extending the relations multiple blocks at a time gives us very good performance and scalability improvement. So now the number of blocks which are to be increased are decided based on the load on the system with a maximum up to 512 blocks. So the people who have like in the beginning they perform the bulk load in their databases, they will see a huge difference in the performance and scalability. At 64 clients, the max peak performance we have seen is up to 5 times the performance has improved. And scaling happens till 8 clients. After that, it almost stabilizes. This shows that there is more work which could be done in this area to improve it further. But as compared to 9.5, this is a very great improvement. And again, this is the case for bulk load only, but when the data doesn't fit in shared buffers. Yeah, so in this also we have seen up to 3.7 times the performance increase at 64 clients. In this also, as compared to, as I have told in the previous slide, that we have improved a lot, but seeing the graphs, you can see that we could still do much more in this area. So this is the work done in 9.6 by my colleague Dilip Kumar, and we could see a huge performance improvement for bulk loads with this work. The next thing I would like to share with you people is that during all the previous work for read-write transactions, I have done some experiments to see where are the further bottlenecks and how we can improve further. So this work is this work could lead to be actual patches, or it could give some hints where are the bottlenecks and we can do more work based on this. So like in the previous slides, I have told that we have reduced the C-log log contention, but still we see there is a chance of more improvement there. Like when many transactions tries to commit at the same time, still there is a good amount of bottleneck over there. And already there are a couple of approaches which are being discussed in the community to resolve that. One of the approaches is to group the transaction commit data, similar to what we have done for proc array lock. Second one is like we could introduce a new C log page level lock. And the most interesting one is that we could convert the whole operation into atomic operations, which means that we don't need any lock. We are still discussing which one is the best way to go forward. And hopefully we will see something related to this in 9.7. The next thing is that I have observed that on the read-write workload, especially using PG bench, when data and wall both are on hard disk, if we increase the segment size of wall, which is currently 16 MB to 32 MB, we see approximately 20% performance improvement at various client counts. So now, actually, one idea is that users who can see such a benefit can build the PostgreSQL code with wall size equal to 32 MB. And can, or maybe PostgreSQL can use this as a default value. But there are a couple of disadvantages as well for increasing the wall size. Something like users, I think, need to do the initDB once again for their database, which is a big problem. And then it could lead to some space wastage and increase in recovery time also. So eventually, we want to come up with some way by taking more performance data and try to find some suitable way so that we can take the advantage of this performance improvement without any disadvantages. So still, this idea hasn't been discussed on Hackers, but I hope to discuss after taking some more data on this. Another stuff I would like to present is about the wall rewrites. Right now, we always write the wall in 8 KB block chunks. So if there, if any transaction or group of transaction writes, let's say data less than 4 KB, actually, we are doing the write twice to it. So this lead to lot of rewrites in the system. I have done few experiments to reduce these rewrites, and one of these experiments is to write the wall in smaller chunks like 4K, which is generally the default for many of the OS buffer sizes. So in this, I have seen approximately 35% reduction in wall rewrites, and also there is a small TPS increase up to from 1 to 5% on different on this workload. The second thing I have tried is writing wall in exact size. Basically, whatever transaction writes, I try to write in the actual size. Whereas this leads to a huge number of reduction in rewrites, but actually it introduces the amount of reads in the system because of misaligned writes. So this doesn't seem to be a good way, but the first one gives a positive advantages. The only thing is that though it reduces the rewrites, but still we are not very happy with the performance improvement it gives. Like you can see, with 35% of reduction in rewrites, it just gives 1 to 5% of improvement. So we are still evaluating whether there are workloads where this such an improvement could lead to a good increase in TPS. But yeah, I have seen that MySQL as well as other databases also uses this technique. So still, it is under evaluation. Yeah.
Have you tried padding out the wall so that you write out 8K, but then the next block is the next write will be in the next 8K?
Oh. So the question is that can we try out something like we pad the system for the writes so that it writes in 8K and the next is in next block. So I have not tried this, but it might be worth trying, and I have not put a thought on this, but I will definitely put a give a thought to it. I think you can share your ideas on hackers. We already have a thread also, so it will be quite meaningful for us to discuss over there. So the next thing is wall write lock contention. After improving the C-log and proc array lock contention, the next highest contention we see is on the wall write lock. This is the lock we take to write the wall, both in OS buffers as well as doing the f-syncing. I have just tried a very rough experiment by hacking the code to just comment out the flush, and I could see at 64 clients the TPS has increased from 27K to 41K. All of us knows that flush has a highest cost, but with this experiment, the numbers are quite clear that it could improve up to 60-70% of the improvement.
But what you're improving here is not the actual lock content.
Yeah. Yeah, right. That's what I am coming with my third point. The point is that the flush is the main cost. So now we are doing two things in the lock. One is writing to the OS buffers, and second is the flush. So we can think of an idea where we could split this work. Like the flush could be done in a separate lock, wall flush lock, and the write could be done in a wall write lock. So I don't know, we have not tried this experiment. This has been discussed a couple of years back on Hackers, but no one has tried this idea till date. So yeah, basically there could be more ways to try to reduce this contention, and needs much more discussion. So yeah, this might be the next bottleneck after improving the work we have done for 9.6. So this is all about the read and write scalability related work. So now, next one is that I will discuss about the other performance improvements we have done in 9.6, which in itself they help a lot for many other kind of use cases. The first one in this is don't vacuum all frozen pages. So this will greatly reduce the cost of anti-wraparound vacuums on large clusters where the majority of the data doesn't change from one cycle to another cycle. And the reason for this is that we don't need to read all those pages which are kind of not touched. So this is a new improvement we have done, and it will reduce the I/O in many workloads. Similarly, there is a new feature added by one of my colleague, Kevin Grittner, like snapshot. We famously called it as snapshot too old. People, whoever has worked in Oracle, they must be knowing this error code. This is a very famous Oracle error code. So what we do with this feature is that we allow the user to control the bloat by vacuuming away the data which is retained in the database for old transactions. And those old transactions, if they try to access this data, then they will get this error, snapshot too old. By this, the real advantage is that we could control a bloat in the system. And one of our customers also got a really very big advantage using this feature. In past few releases, we have done a lot of work in the sorting area by one of the famous hackers, Peter. And in this release also, again, we have improved the sorting in a major way. The basic idea is to use a quick sort instead of replacement sort during external sorting. And this makes the sorting faster, except for the cases when the work memory is less. Then the next improvement is that we have started using index-only scan with partial indexes in many more cases than the current its use. Basically, the cases where it improves is when the restriction clause that is not part of the index key is implied by the index predicate. So this also improves the performance for many cases. The next improvement done is like for the cases where there is a join on multiple columns. As of now, the planner has produces the plan for such cases by assuming default selectivity. And but now, if there is a foreign key in such cases of join, we use that information and generate better plans. And the next thing is for very short two-phase transactions, there could be a speed up to 50 to 100% with this feature. And this is mainly by avoiding the writes and file syncing during this two-phase commit. The next very interesting work we have done to improve the performance is that combining the aggregates to avoid the duplicate effort. For example, if you see in this case the two aggregates average and sum, in this for such aggregates there is a common work that needs to be done. Earlier it used to be done separately for calculating value for both the aggregates, but now we have started sharing that work, and it gives a very big speed up for the cases where multiple aggregates are getting used. And next in the area of performance improvement is that we have improved the cases, like we are now avoiding the pin scan during the replay of the B-tree vacuum record. So how this helps is, earlier it used to cause in replication delays from seconds to minutes when such records get replayed in the replication. But now, as we have avoided the pin scan, it greatly improves that delay. Means it has greatly reduced that delay. So this is all about the work you are going to see for in 9.6. I will also briefly like to share about the work in the performance and scalability we have done from 9.1 to 9.5. This is mostly about the performance data, how the performance has improved. So the whole data performance data is taken on a very high-end machine, Intel x86, with 8 sockets, 64 cores, and 128 hardware threads with 500 GB RAM. Here, our idea was not to extract maximum TPS from the system. This machine is mainly, the performance tests are done on this machine mainly to see the behavior and improvements, what we can do for 8-socket, higher socket machines. And these are some of the non-default PostgreSQL settings which we have used for taking the performance data. So the first case we can see is read-write workload where the data fits in shared buffers. Here you can see from 9.1 to 9.5, almost on each release, we are constantly improving the performance as well as scalability. Overall, if we see, there is an increase of 118% from 9.1 to 9.5 in peak performance. I still know many people are not much aware that there has been huge improvement in PostgreSQL in terms of performance after 9.1. Though we have added many, many great features also during this period, but the performance also has improved in a great way. Now, this is the second workload where again a read-write workload, but when the data doesn't fit in shared buffers, however it fits in the RAM. So here also we see a very good performance improvement, although not as amazing as for the case when data fits in shared buffers. Here we see an approximately 73% performance improvement from 9.1 to 9.5. And in between also each release, you can see there is a constant performance and scalability improvement. The next one is for the read-only workload when the data fits in shared buffers. Here, the main improvement we see is from 9.1 to 9.2, like for 414% of peak performance improvement, and this is mainly due to the work of fast path locks, which has been done by Robert Haas. After that, on this machine, kind of machines, we are not seeing much improvement in any of the versions. But yeah, overall performance has been greatly improved. And one thing is that during our test runs, we have seen across around 9.4 version, due to unaligned shared memory data structures, there is sometimes the performance variation. So that's one of the observations I would like to share. That's why I mentioned. But now the case, if we see the read-only workload where the data doesn't fit in shared buffers. Here we see an improvement across multiple versions. And we could see 367% performance improvement in 9.5 as compared to 9.1 at its peak performance. So yeah, this is also a really, really great improvement from 9.1 till 9.5. In the end, I would like to thank my colleagues Dilip and Mithun, who have helped me in taking all the performance data or part of the performance data taken in this presentation. I'm done. So, is your question is that what is the nature of changes we have done? How it impacts the workload if you want to change? Okay, actually, okay, the question is that how destructive changes we have done and how it impacts the code which has done all these improvements and locking. During our work, actually, we have not seen any reports of the data corruption or any such sort. There are few, but not many changes, or sorry, not many reports have came. And the changes are just the way the locks are acquired. So they are not fundamentally changing anything around data. So I don't feel that, my gut feeling is that it should not harm customers in terms of data corruption or anything like that. No, actually, you are right that this is one of the major fear from both Robert as well as Andres, who have looked into this work. But we have seen that we have done extensive testing to see that there should not be any impact on that linear search algorithm from increasing from 32 to 128. And in fact, we have seen as soon as we increase from 128 to 256, there is an impact. So we have increased up till 128. Yes.
Did you observe any NUMA, negative NUMA behavior, or was NUMA a non-issue for you?
No, there are many issues due to NUMA access, but the one idea to take on this machine is that we want to see how on such a high NUMA nodes we are improving and what are the more bottlenecks. And the further study of our work could be that now how to reduce further the NUMA effects. In fact, one of my colleague, Kevin Greitner, has a patch also to reduce it, but still we haven't tried that extensively on this high-end NUMA machine.
I mean, did you take any measurements to see that if you were getting, I mean, sometimes I think NUMA's a false.
Yes. So not exactly for this data we are seeing any problems, variation problems, but for our internal product, when we were doing testing on this machine, we are seeing that if we ensure that our test runs on one NUMA node only, in couple of cases, it gives better performance and reduces the performance variation. So there are effects and we are still trying to study on it, but this data doesn't have effect. Although if the NUMA nodes have been lesser, maybe the performance could be more.
No, I think actually the performance variations you saw with where the padding may have such big an influence is actually very NUMA related. I don't think you can reproduce it without having NUMA.
Oh, yeah, okay. That nine, you are telling in 9.4 where we are seeing that.
Yeah, in any, all of the releases, yeah.
Yeah. So,
a question and a comment. The question is for the new wall flushing parameters.
Okay.
Do we have any idea currently of guidelines of how to tinker with them?
So, not wall, data flushing, I think. Yeah, so the right now whatever the default values we have kept, it might not be the best values, but we have done lot of testing, especially by Andres and Fabian in the community, and a few others also, that those are the best default values. But I think as such, there are no major guidelines till now, and I think this is one of the areas where more testing and more usage we need, and community wants some feedback so that we can tune it better.
So I think the tuning for the checkpoint part of it is pretty easy. It doesn't have that much influence. The one where it's much more riskier is the backend flush after, because if you have a workload that's bigger than shared memory but a lot smaller, like less than 20% of the OS cache, then the flushing can have a noticeable detrimental performance effect, and that also depends on the kernel version and whatnot. So in that case, you might actually want to disable the feature. So that's, I think it's only backend flush after that has that
negative impact. Yeah.
The comment I was going to make is that not for a few Postgres versions now, but back in the 8 series, I experimented extensively with changing the size of wall log segments.
Oh.
And found that performance gain or loss was highly workload dependent.
Okay.
So to the point where I my advice was actually don't mess with this, because unless you have the time to test your workload.
Sorry.
Yeah. Go ahead.
So the suggestion by Josh Burkus is that the experiment I have shared related to increase in wall segments. In some cases, as I have shown for read-write workload, it improves the performance. Josh is mentioning that it could have a negative impact as well for other kind of workloads. So it is better not to mess unless we have more solid proofs.
Okay.
Yeah. Currently, it is code level configuration, but yeah, until we have more experiment, I have discussed this with both Andres Hackey as well as Robert, that until we have more proofs or more data in this area, which I might plan to take in the next version, I think making it configurable through GUC and all would not be advisable. So right now it is, that's why I have mentioned if somebody wants actually and their workload is giving the performance benefit, they can use it via the configure option. They can build the code of their own. There is an option. It is not that there is no option at this stage, but you have to build the code with that option. Thanks. Any more questions? Okay. Thanks very much for attending this presentation.